The iPhone XR's display is an IPS-LCD, and under the microscope we can see strips of three colors. Its resolution is only 1790 by 828, which means we can't enjoy 2K videos. The iPhone XS's display is an OLED with a resolution of 2436 by 1125. Looking under the microscope, the iPhone XS's pixels appear in three color squares. The highest brightness of the LCD is lower than that of the OLED, and the thickness is larger than that of the OLED. Therefore, we can see that the screen of the iPhone XR is darker. In order to limit the thickness of the screen, the iPhone XR cancels the function of the 3D touch. Start disassembling now. First, turn off the phone and remove the SIM card tray. In order not to disturb the position of the screw, I glued the screw to the double-sided tape and wrote the numbers. Heat the sides of the phone with a heat gun for 5 minutes at a temperature of 80 degrees Celsius. Use a suction cup to suck up the lower end of the screen and insert an ultra-thin plastic card. Use a plastic card to cut the glue under the screen. Insert a thicker plastic card into the corner of the seam and cut the waterproof glue on the edge of the screen. This time, we will take out the iPhone XR's battery and see if it is compatible with the iPhone XS. And we will take apart the Taptic Engine and see its internal structure. Gently lift the screen and notice the cable below the screen. Remove the screws on the motherboard in turn, taking care not to disturb their order. I found the internal structure of the iPhone XR to look like the iPhone 8. The motherboard is not a two-layer structure like the iPhone X. The shape of the battery is also different from the iPhone X. Disconnect power before removing the screen. We must first disconnect the battery while we are repairing the phone, otherwise the motherboard may be short-circuited. The next step is to remove the battery from the iPhone XR. Heating the back cover helps to soften the glue under the battery. The gap between the battery and the vibration motor is relatively small, so be careful not to poke the battery when using the tweezers. Slowly pull the battery adhesive out. Is the iPhone XR battery compatible with iPhone XS? Load the iPhone XR battery into the iPhone XS. The phone can be turned on and used normally. As a result of the experiment, the batteries of the iPhone XR and iPhone XS are compatible with each other, although their shapes are different. Remove the front camera. The front camera module includes IR camera, front camera, and dot projector. In addition to the front camera module, the Face ID requires a light sensor. The light sensor is located on the ear speaker module on the back of the screen. This module combines a microphone, an earpiece, and a light sensor. A metal clip that holds the earpiece. carefully remove the motherboard. The iPhone XR's motherboard is a single-layer structure. Remove the protective layer on the surface, and we can see the chips inside. The iPhone X has a two-layer structure that requires a heater to separate the two-layer motherboard. The heating temperature was 200 degrees Celsius, and the temperature should be constant and uniform. We have come to the long-awaited Taptic Engine. The iPhone 8's Taptic Engine is the biggest. We took the iPhone 8 and the iPhone XR's Taptic Engine apart and found a combination of coils and movable magnets. According to the principle of electromagnetic induction, the coil generates different magnetic fields by the change of current and then drives the magnet under the coil to perform different movements. It took a lot of time to open the Taptic Engine. Its metal protective layer is difficult to break open. Many people associate 3D touch with the Taptic Engine and think that since the iPhone XR doesn't have a 3D touch, it can use a smaller vibrator to save space for the battery and motherboard. In fact, the iPhone used to adopt a vibrator patented by Samsung. Taptic Engine is a very unique vibrator developed by Apple. Apple applies it to all its products, including Apple Watches. The iPhone 8's Taptic Engine has a total of 6 magnets, with lubricant on the magnet to prevent wear between the magnet and the coil. Continue our teardown. We need to unscrew the screws on the charging cable. Pick up the charging cable. There's a small amount of glue under the charging cable. Carefully use a spudger to pick up the signal line on the back cover. There are 6 screws on the Wi-Fi antenna. Finally, remove the wireless charging coil. It is not difficult to remove the wireless charging coil, but the action is slow. Be careful not to break the cable. At this point, the iPhone XR parts have been completely removed.